He was born in Isfahan under the name of Amir Hassan Aghilipour in 1929. And later on, when I was seeing his passport, you know, I said, "Dad, what is this 1939? He said, "Well, I looked 1939. His military career started in 1946 at the Iranian Academy of the War.
He was a very proud man, very military man, very strong man. He wasn't a type of man who was going to die laying down.
My dad loved politics. All his life he was in politics.
You know his story. He was, you know, he joined the military, became a diplomat, and his life was all about politics. He loved politics.
In 1959, he got married to my mom here. And this is where his foreign assignment started. First, he went to France to become the French Institut International d'Administration Publique. After that, in 1973, he went back to France after a few years passage at Tehran and become at the École Supérieure de Guerre, 87th promotion. In 1975, he became the military attaché of the Iranian Imperial Army in France, Spain, Switzerland, Belgium, Portugal, and the special accreditation to NATO. 15 years that he spent in France, he also earned two PhDs, first one in sociology and the second one in international affairs. In 1981, he founded the Foundation for the Independence of Iran. In 1987, he formed the Iranian Crisis Cabinet in Exile. And in 1989, he created the Iranian Human Rights Commission in Exile and testified of the human rights violation in front of the United Nations. He had three failed assassination attempts to his life, and no details needed. And so this is when the French government told him, "We cannot guarantee anymore your protection and your life." He went under the French protection program and he became Jean-Jacques Aguilier. And for some GG. Cash and I were saying, "Dad, come on, you need to learn to speak English." He said, "So finally we were able to write his name at the San Pedro Adult School." And we have a picture of him. He's sitting here, big smile, with about 15 Hispanic gentlemen and ladies around him, and big smile. So he goes first day, second day, third day. And one night he comes here. I said, "Did you go to the classes?" He said, yeah, 10 minutes. I said, "What do you mean 10 minutes? He said, "Can you believe it?" I said, "No, what?" He said, "The English teacher doesn't even speak French." This was his life, political and career. But to Kashyana, he was our father. After that, like the poet said, "Rumi, you are not a drop in the ocean, you are a mighty ocean in the drop." And this is who he was to me and Kashyana. If I may ask everyone to stand up for the national anthem of Iran.
جان ما پاینده باد که ایران ما زنده باد ایران.
Please be seated.
I always remember those words. Those are the most important words he told me. He said, "Son, I can get up in the morning and look at myself in the mirror." At the time, it didn't make sense. I know I got upset at him. I didn't speak to him for a few years. And gradually, I learned what it meant. And you still probably wonder, because you look at me and say, well, who is this? Look at this guy. You see this picture up there? Wow, what a good looking guy, man. Nobody, and I get this every other week, if not, you know, I've been getting this all my life. He says, this cannot be your dad. What a good looking guy. What happened to you, you know? I said, well, you know, I didn't get the genes. My brother got all the good look genes, you know? That's my dad. I did a DNA check, you know? He keeps telling me, essence of life is time. Everything comes and goes, time only goes by. He understood life. We all coming, we all going. Understood.
I want to read a little French sentence of a Saadi poet, of a Persian poet. He says, roam aboard the world and take the feel of its enjoyment before the day shall come when you must put it for good. His life was like that. He roamed aboard the world all over his world. Peder Aziz, dear father, death changes everything. Time changes nothing. We miss the sound of your voice, the wisdom of your advice, the stories of your life. And just simply being in your presence. No, time changes nothing. We miss you as much today as we did the day you died, and for the rest of our lives, we just miss you.
Here's a toast to the prime gentleman. He's gone, but he's not gone. I won't see you soon. Thank you all for being here. And here's to the prime gentleman. Thank you very much.